नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज जेवियंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक बायोफ्यूल्स एंड द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द बायोफ्यूल्स, एंड दिस बिलोंग्स टू द सब्जेक्ट और द कोर्स द रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी एंड ग्रीन टेक्नोलॉजी। सो बायोफ्यूल्स आर एक्चुअली दे आर द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन फ्यूल्स लाइक द इथेनॉल एंड बायोडीजल that are made from the biomass material. So these fuels are usually blended with the petroleum fuels, namely with gasoline and diesel fuels, but they can also be used on their own. So ethanol and biodiesel are also cleaner burning fuels and producing fewer air pollution. It has drawn significant attention due to the increasing environmental concern and diminishing petroleum reserves. So biodiesel fuel can be made from renewable vegetable oil, animal fats, or recycled cooking oils by transesterification process. Biodiesel is the fastest growing alternative fuel in the world because the available resources of fuels or the petroleum, etc., they have the limited storage and limited amount. But the biofuels are produced by the biomass, and biomass is naturally occurring and reoccur in the nature. So ethanol is an alcohol fuel made from the sugars found in grains such as corn, sorghum, and wheat, as well as potato skins, rice, sugarcane, sugar beets, and yard clipping by fermentation. So, characteristics of the biofuels. So, there are some of the characteristics of the efficient biofuels which are mentioned here. That first is the kinematic viscosity. Second is density, means it has some density, it has some calorific value, it has some specific melt or pour point, it has some specific cloud point, it has some specific flash point, and acid value, iodine value, cation number, stability in the oxidative and storage and thermal, the carbon residue, what is the ash percentage here, what is the sulfur percentage in that. So these are the characteristics of biofuel. So let's discuss one by one. So first is the kinematic viscosity. So what is that? So viscosity and the tendency of fluids to deform with stress. So viscosity affects the injector lubrication and fuel atomization. The fuels with low viscosity may not provide sufficient lubrication for the precision fit of fuel injection pumps, resulting in the leakage or increased wear. So fuel atomization is also affected by fuel viscosity. So diesel fuels with high viscosity tend to form larger droplets on injection, which can cause poor combustion, increase the exhaust smoke and emission. Second characteristics or property is the density. So it is the weight per unit volume. So oils that are denser contain more energy. For example, the petrol and diesel fuels give comparable energy by weight, but diesel is denser and hence gives more energy per liter. So biodiesel is generally denser than the diesel fuel, with sample values ranging between 877 kg per meter cube to 884 kg per meter cube, compared with the diesel at 835 kilometer per meter cube, kilogram per meter cube. So thus the density of the final product depends mostly on the feedstock used. Okay, next the characteristics is the calorific value, heat of combustion. So heating value or heat of combustion is the amount of heating energy released by the combustion of a unit value of the fuels. One of the most important determinants of heating value is moisture content. So So liquid biofuels, however, have bulk densities comparable to those for fossil fuels. Next is the melting point or the pour point. So melt or pour point refers to the temperature at which one is solid form, at which oil in solid form starts to melt or pour. So in case where the temperatures fall below the melt point, the entire fuel system include all fuel lines and fuel tank will needed to be heated. Okay, so next one is the cloud point. What is cloud point? So cloud point is the temperature at which an oil starts to solidify is known as the cloud point. Okay, so before solidifying, it gets turbid. Some turbidity will be shown, and you see that the clouds are turbid. Okay, so that's why it is named as the cloud point. So the temperature at which an oil starts to solidify is known as the cloud point. While operating an engine at temperatures below an oil's cloud point, heating will be necessary in order to avoid the waxing of the fuel. Okay, if heating is not there, then the fuel will be solidify and it will not work, it will not function. Okay, then next is the flash point. What is the flash point? So flash point, the flash point temperature of diesel fuel is the minimum temperature at which the fuel will ignite or flash. Okay, so an application of the ignition source, flash point varies inversely with the fuel's volatility. Okay, minimum flash point temperatures are required for proper safety and handling of diesel fuels. So the flash point determines the flammability of the material. The net biodiesel has a flash point of 150 degrees Celsius, well above the flash point of petroleum-based diesel fuels, that is 70 degrees Celsius. So next is the acid value. So the total acid number is an indication of the presence of fatty acids formed due to oil degradation and combustion. It can also result from improper manufacturing through remaining catalyst or the excessive neutralization. Okay, so it is the processing based problem. So next is the iodine value. So it is an index of the number of double bonds in biodiesel, and therefore it is a parameter that quantifies the degree of unsaturation of biodiesel, because we measure the unsaturation by the number of double bonds and triple bonds. So if more double bond and triple bonds is there, that is the more unsaturation is there. So it is reported in terms of the grams of iodine that will react with 100 grams of a fat or oil under specified conditions. It is a value of the amount of iodine measured in gram absorbed by 100 grams of given oil. So it is commonly used as a measure of the chemical stability property of different biodiesel fuels against such oxidation. Okay. So next characteristic is the aniline point or cation number, CN. So it is a relative measure of the interval between the beginning of injection and auto ignition of the fuel. So the higher the cation number, the shorter the delay interval and the greater its combustibility. So fuels with low cation numbers will result in difficult starting, will result in noise, will result in exhaust smoke. So in general, diesel engines will operate better on fuels with cation numbers above 50. So Katen number is usually measured directly using a test engine. Katen test provide information on the ignition quality of a diesel fuel. Number two, diesel fuel quality usually has a Katen rating between the 45 to 50, while vegetable oils have between the 35 to 45. Biodiesel is usually have between the 50 and 60. Then stability. So biodiesel ages more quickly than petroleum diesel fuel due to the chemical structure of fatty acid and the methyl ester present in the biodiesel. Typically, there are 14 types of fatty acid methyl esters in the biodiesel. The individual proportion of presence of these esters in the fuel affects the final properties of the biodiesel. So poor oxidation stability can cause fuel thickening in formation of gums and the sediments, which in turn cause filter clogging and the injector flowing. So thermal degradation occurs at higher temperatures and degrades the hyperoxide in the fuel more rapidly than oxidative degradation. Biodiesel and biodiesel blends are much more thermally stable than the diesel, and biodiesel and its blends should not be stored in a storage tank or vehicle tank more than 6 months, depending upon the storage temperature and other conditions, suggest the use of the appropriate antioxidants. Next is the carbon residue. So this indicates the tendency of fuel to form the carbon deposits in the engine. An important indicator of the quality of biodiesel is the carbon residue, which corresponds to the content of glycerides, free acids, soaps, polymers, and remaining catalysts. So next is the ash percent. Ash is the measure of the amount of metals contained in the fuels. So high concentration of these metals can cause injector tip plugging, combustion deposits, and injection system wear. So the ash content is important for the heating value, as heating value decreases with increasing ash content. So ash content for biofuels is typically lower than for the most coals, and the sulfur contents is much lower than the many fossil fuels. Then the sulfur percentage is the percentage by weight of sulfur in the fuel. Sulfur content is limited by low of to very small percentage for diesel fuels used in on-road applications. The first use vegetable oils and animal fat based biodiesels has less than 50 ppm sulfur. So many researchers claim that pure biodiesel is essentially sulfur free, and therefore biodiesel is an ultra low sulfur fuel. Okay, so these was the about the biofuel, its characteristics, various characteristics we have discussed, the various characteristics of the biofuels here. So hope you are satisfied with this little session, and if you have any query, please write in the comment box. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.